Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone, we are from group 1, want to discussion. Our discussion, the topic is the assembly of insect resistant plants uses genes from microorganisms, insects and other animals. Our member is Hanan Zaki Naufal with student number 134190219, and then Muhammad Nusa Irawan Munte 134190010, and then Sartika Sari 134190011, and then Rehatun Mustaqimah 134190032, and then Ahmad Ahsanul Fahmi 134190041, and then Ridwan 134190043, and then Dwi Cahyo Budi Bakti with student number 134190048, and then Ismi Aflaha Mariah with student number 134190051.
The definition of biotechnology. Biotechnology comes into words. Bio contains the meaning of living bodies or organism, and technology a collection of methods developed to answer problem or to produce something useful. Biotechnology has been defined as methods that are based on the use of organism to answer problems or produce something useful for human life. Genetically engineered plant resistant to pest insect. Assembly of pest resistant plants can be done through transgenic. Transgenic plants are plants that have been engineered in shape or quality through and the insertion of genes or DNA of animals, bacteria, microbes, or virus for a specific purpose. Transgenic plant manufacturing is by means that identified genes are isolated and then incorporated into plant cell. Before transgenic plants are assembled, it is necessary to prioritize the type of or species of pest that will be controlled with the GMO plants to be assembled.
Genes for insect pest resistance. Genes are genetic factors that play a major role in determining the nature of living things. Genetically modified plants, reign after reverted to as transgenic plants, can be engineered to have resistance to certain types of pests. Plant-derived genes are derived genes that plants get from other living things such as other plants or insects. Although insecticides are known to be synthetic compounds, there are also natural insecticides found in the genes of bacteria, trees, and flowers. First, Bacillus thuringiensis. Bacillus thuringiensis, or BT gene, that including the delta endotoxin in plants, will produce toxins continuously, so sensitive insects that live in plant tissue will die if they consume these compounds. But because the protein toxin produced are only active for certain type of insect, a pest-resistant transgenic plant can only control certain type of pests too. And transgenic plants will be protected from pests as long as protein toxins are still being produced. And in the international world, the transgenic plants that have been inserted with genes derived from Bacillus thuringiensis include cotton, corn, and potatoes. Second is inhibitor alpha amylase. Alpha amylase inhibitors are proteins that inhibit the enzyme amylase in the digestive tracts of insects. Amylase enzymes are needed especially by insects that eat grains and sweet potatoes, which are rich in starch. By inhibiting the breakdown of starch by amylase inhibitors, insects don't get their carbohydrate needs, so it can be fatal for these insects. And several types of alpha amylase inhibitors have been isolated from various plant seeds such as Spatiolus vulgaris and Triticum aestivum. The alpha amylase inhibitor of Spatiolus vulgaris inhibited the amylase activity of crude extract from the midgut of Lepidoptera insects like Spodoptera littoralis.
Okay, next genes for insect pest resistance, inhibitor lectins. Lectins are proteins that can be monocyte hybrids and oligocyte hybrids specifically, but are not enzymes and differ from antibodies in that lectins cannot produce an immune response. Lectin inhibitor are proteins that can inhibit lectin jumps. Next inhibitor, protein protocyte. Protocyte inhibitor are that can inhibit that enzyme protocyte to hydrolyze peptin bonds in proteins into oligopeptin and amino acids. Gain transfer chelates in plants. Directs examples are that plant of gans with gain gans or in vortex with silicon carbide DZN. Treatment on plant protoplasts with electroporation or with polyethylenglycol. Indirect gain transfer is through vector Agrobacterium.
Then direct gain transfer. In direct gain transfer, there are three. First, particle bombardment. This method of gain transfer is physically operated by firing DNA code particles directly into a plant cell or tissue. In this way, the transformed particle and DNA penetrate the cell wall and membrane. Then the DNA constrict and disperse inside the cell independently. Second, silicon carbide. In this method, the suspension of the plant cell to be transformed mixed with silicon carbide fiber and plasmid DNA from the desired gain is inserted into the Eppendorf tube, then mixed and played back with the vortex. Silicon carbide fiber serve as micro-injection needles to facilitate the transfer of DNA into plant cell. Third, electroporation. Electroporation with high voltage treatment causes temporary high permeability of the cell membrane by forming pores so that DNA can easily enter the protoplast. The membrane integrity returns to normal within seconds to a minute after electrical treatment. Then indirect gain transfer. Many gain transfer techniques that have developed, but the vector technique Agrobacterium tumefaciens is most often used to transform decoy plant. Agrobacterium tumefaciens is able to transfer gain into the plant genome through explant in the form of leaf, disc or other part of plant tissue that have high regenerating potential.
Insect pest resistant management. The extent of plant development raises concern the PRG plant resistant genes. Example, the PT genes become no longer resistant to concerned pests, giving rise to new and more virulent biotypes. This is from Herman 2008. This is based on continuous research on the target insect pest, which will cause genetic change in the insect's body so that it becomes resistant or there is a failure of plant resistance. The broken resistance of PRG plants to target insect pests is caused by several possibilities. There are, first, high adoption of TSH PRG plants by farmers. Second, imperfect control of target insect pests. Third, high rate of insect pest attack. Fourth, lack of planting refugia plants. That is from PENA 2010. According to Apply et al. 2009, the management of insect pest resistance requires several strategies, including their first, the uses of high dust. Second, keep the target insect pest population vulnerable by planting 20 until 50% refugia. There are non-PRG plants or crop rotation with non-PRG varieties or mixing PRG seeds with non-PRG. Third, for the last, diversification of source of resistance gains. The third strategy is to combine two gains with different modes of action or pyramid gains.
Organic plant production requirement. The basic information as an indication that the product meets the requirement of environmental, food and feed safety. Number one is description of pure fields of use. Number two, detect expected genetic or phenotype change shall be detected. Number three, clear identity regarding the taxonomy of PRGs, ecology and reproduction. Number four, the organism used as the source of the gain must be clearly or completely stated. Number five, the method used follows standard procedures that can be scientifically justified. Number six, molecular characterization of PRGs must be in clear detail. Number seven, expression of gens transformed to PRG must be stable. Number eight, the content of toxic, anti-nutritional, and allergic compounds in PRG must be substantially equivalent to B of on PRG. And the last one, how to destroy if there is a deviation. Okay, next slide. Biotechnology method for plant in improvement. Prior to that, it is necessary to prioritize the types of species of pests to be controlled with transgenic plants to be assembled. Point one, look for pests that do not have a source of resistance. Gains from their mass plant species. Their host plant species. And the last, number two, determine which candidate resistant gain will be used, such as BT toxin, proteinase inhibitor or PI, or other resistant gains.
Global development of transgenic crops resulting from biotechnology. The assembly of pest-resistant transgenic plant is an alternative technology that can be used in controlling pests. Since being introduced in 1996, plant utilization of GMOs is on the rise. ISAAA records transgenic plants. The most plants until currently are cotton, corn, soybeans, and canola. But research is not just stopped at four commodities just that. A number of countries are developed plants that according to needs and character agricultural land and plantations each. Brazil, for example, developed virus-resistant beans that have obtained approval for cultivation.
That is our presentation. If there a question about our topic, you can put the question in comment section. Thank you.